Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it.
Must be or not, must be or not. Jesus must be or not in my life every day. Hallelujah. God must be or not. Must be or not, must be or not. Jesus must be or not in my life every day. Did you sing with me with all your heart? Because you should remember, it's the word in Numbers 14:28. As you are spoken in his ears, so he will do unto you. God must be honored. Must be honored, must be honored. Jesus must be honored in my life every day. Our Father and our God, our help in ages past, the Word from the beginning, the God who can never be too late. You are a timely God. We thank you, we bless you, we worship you, we adore you for all you have done in our lives. Thank you for every timely intervention you have been giving us since the beginning of the year till now. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Thank you for the word of life with which you are feeding us. Father, we thank you. Accept our praises in Jesus' name. We thank you specifically for yesterday, Lord. We thank you for sending your word to us to encourage us. We thank you for sending your word to us to assure us. Because one thing we know, heaven and earth may pass away. Not a jot of your word will go unfulfilled. We know as long as we remain on your side, everything will work together for our good. It doesn't matter what the situation around us may be. We know that it will be for our good. We know, we are convinced that the end result will bring glory to your name. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Father, this is another day. We want to hear your voice. Please speak to us in Jesus' name. Correct us through your word in Jesus' name. Father, chastise us through your word in Jesus' name. Establish us through your word in Jesus' name. Peradventure, there are some sick people viewing this program. Lord, I ask that the power in your word will deliver healings to them in the name of Jesus. For it is written, you sent out your word. Your word healeth them and delivered them from their destructions. As many as are having bodily ailments viewing this program, heal them in the name of Jesus. Limba sakaramba lilala yakotoro muzo kolonda yakata ne yenge libra bakacha chali de yenge lembruko chocho. Whatever the nature of the sickness may be, my Father, ne keri gadanda libra kacha chali de yenge lembruko chocho liaba. Because there is power in your word, heal them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In case there are some backsliders being this program, eternal in the heavens. Inasmuch it has pleased you to cause them to be viewing this program right now, restore them fully back unto yourself in Jesus' name. To you be all the glory, all the honor, all the worship. For the remaining few days of this year, satisfy your people. I present all my viewers before you, satisfy them. Almighty God, satisfy them. Ne kundurumu za kalanda ya yenge libra bakachacha le nkoromo yenge libra mazante et libre bekechacha ne hindurumu sukuta lande yekeliamba. Because they are viewers of this program, Almighty God, satisfy them with physical blessings, satisfy them with spiritual blessings, satisfy them with your anointing, satisfy them, Father. All that we make their life to be good, release upon them in Jesus' name. Thank you, Ancient of Days. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God will satisfy you in the name of Jesus. Today is Saturday, 23rd of December. I'm pausing. Unfortunately, I didn't check the time to. Okay. Today is Saturday, 23rd of December. The topic says marriage. Then under the broad topic, marriage, what do we want to talk about? Companionship. Companionship. If you ask some people today, why did you get married? It will amaze you a lot of reasons they will give to you. Some may say, I'm old enough, then get married. Some may tell you, the way they are sending me on errand in the house, everybody do this, do that. I want my own home. That's why I got married. Some may tell you, well, I want children. I want to become the mother of so and so. So I get married. But from the light of the scriptures, why is marriage? One of it is companionship. Our memory verse is taken from Genesis chapter 2, verse 18. And according to my custom, because it's part of the text, we will read it together. The text is Genesis 2, 15 to 18. Genesis chapter 2, verse 15, verse 16, verse 17, and verse 18. And the Lord God took the man and put him into the garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not eat of it. For in the day that thou eatest thereof, thou shalt surely die. 18. And the Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him an help meet for him. An help meet for him means an helper comparable to him. Now, the few verses we have read, number one thing that I can see in verse 15 is that every man is supposed to be working. God wants us to work. Man must work. Because nowadays you see some people, they are just lazy. They want everything free, free, free. They don't want to work. Particularly if they are privileged to live in civilized nation whereby they give them some money every month. They don't want to work. And that is contrary to the plan of the one who created man. The Bible says, and the Lord God took the man and put him into the garden of Eden to do what? To dress it. Is to tend it, is to cultivate it. But what do we find today? Some men will prefer to sleep and sleep. They are looking for free money. It negates the counsel of God. Proverbs 12. Let's turn our Bibles quickly to Proverbs. Because I like establishing everything I say with the word of God. So that if the devil wants to deceive you, you'll be able to say, no, I know what the word has said. Proverbs chapter 12, then we look at verse 27. He says, the slothful man roasteth not that which he took in hunting, but the substance of a diligent man is precious. Slothful people. They are too lazy that they can't even feed themselves. If a slothful man will go and hunt, he will not be able to even prepare the meal to eat it. Are you a slothful person? If you are slothful, you need to change. Because God has not created any one of us to be a liability in life. Proverbs 21:25. The desire of the slothful killeth him, for his hands refuse to labor. When they see good car, hey, I love to have that car. See that Mercedes 300. See that Mercedes 500. They keep on wishing. They never walk, so their wish never come to pass. But what does the Bible say in 2 Thessalonians 3:10? 2 Thessalonians chapter 3 and verse 10. It says, for even when we were with you, this we commended you, that if any man will not work, neither should he eat. The word of God says, if you are a lazy person, you are not fit to eat. So let's stop at that. I just trying to expatiate on Genesis 2:15 that man supposed to work. But when you go to verse 18, that happens to be our memory verse, you will see that the idea of marriage is not any man's idea. Marriage is God's own idea. And that is why the devil is always fighting against homes. That's why the devil is always against marriages. The moment you are married, they begin to bring all sorts of problems to you that at times you find some people say, no, I'm done. I can't cope again. It's the devil fighting against everything that is God. Marriage is God's own idea. And the one who instituted marriage is against divorce. On no account should any true child of God consider divorce as an alternative. How do I mean? Malachi chapter 2, verse 14 to 16. Malachi 2, 14 to 16. Yet ye say, wherefore, because the Lord hath been witness between thee and the wife of thy youth, against whom thou hast dealt treacherously, yet is she thy companion and the wife of thy covenant, and did not he make one? Yet are thee the residue of the Spirit, and wherefore one? That ye might seek a godly seed, therefore take it to your spirit, and let none deal treacherously against the wife of his youth. For the Lord, take note, for the Lord, the God of Israel, seeth that he hated putting away, that is divorce. For one covereth violence with his garment, saith the Lord of hosts, therefore take it to your spirit, that ye deal not treacherously. God hates divorce. God is against divorce. So on no account should any true child of God consider divorce. Matthew 19, 5 and 6. Matthew chapter 19, verse 5 and 6. And said, for this cause shall a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh. Wherefore they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. We go to court, we go and divorce. Oh, we divorce legally. No. It's contrary to the will of God. He has joined you together. It is the death do you part. Then quickly, before we go into the explanation that he puts here for us, I want us to look at the later part of that memory verse. It says, I will make him an helpmeet for him. If you look at Proverbs 31:12, the Bible says you are supposed to do your husband good all the days of his life. You are supposed to be an asset to your husband, not a liability. The question is, as a wife, that God has created to be an helper for your husband, are you a pillar of support to him or a caterpillar? Are you building his life or you are pulling his life down? Some women, when they come to the life of a man, they destroy the life of a man. They tear the life apart. They destroy the good destiny God ordained for that fellow. Are you that kind fellow of a woman? We should all know the purpose why we are being created. We are to be an helper. We are to help our husband to achieve their God-given purpose in life. God will help us in Jesus' name. Quite a number of people today enter into marriage for all the wrong reasons. Like I said earlier, so many wrong reasons make some people to go into marriage. Which is why we need to ask ourselves this question, why marriage? The first reason is companionship. If you look at the scriptures, God said it is not good for a man to be alone. So the reason for marriage is not for procreation. Though it's part of it. But God has not said, oh, it is not good for this man to be alone. I will give him a wife so that he can replenish the earth. Mm-mm. It's not good for him to be alone. I will give him somebody, an help fit for him. Somebody to keep him company. Somebody to share his joy and his sorrow with. The first reason is companionship. To fully understand God's purpose, let's take a look at the beginning. After God had created the firmament, the seas, all plants and animals, he afterwards made man in the Garden of Eden. He ensured that all that man need to enjoy life with is already created. He now created man as the crown of creation. However, as he watched life unfold, he realized that of all the creatures, it was only Adam who had no one of his kind. Can you see? Sheep, they are in twos, male and female. Goats, they are in two, male and female. Cows, every creature. Only Adam has nobody that looks like him. He doesn't look like goats. Neither does he look like a fish. Though he's in charge of everything, he gave name to every creature, but there is nobody like him. There is nobody he can share his emotion with. Let's continue. The trees could reproduce through their seeds. The animals also had male and female species and could thereby multiply. Adam only was the lone ranger in this earthly paradise. And if you are old enough to marry and you are yet to be connected with your spouse, you know how lonely you feel in the world. Though your siblings are there, your parents are there, your colleagues are there in the office, yet there is a vacuum in your life. There is this extreme feeling of loneliness. So, God knew that Adam was feeling lonely. Though he was in charge, he was the God of the whole earth as at that time. Indeed, all animals, birds, and fish submitted to him. And true, he had a great relationship with them all. But God still saw that there was an issue of loneliness with Adam that no pet or animal could solve. That people deceive themselves today. They say they don't want to marry. They make pets their spouse. We've added people get married to their dog. Can the dog talk back to you? Yes, dogs are trained. It can only bark. Dog cannot wake up and say, good morning, darling. Oh, honey, don't keep long as we are going out. Dog cannot feel your emotion. So God saw that there is nobody that can suit Adam. No pet, no animal could solve this problem of loneliness. And that's why we have it recorded in Genesis 2:18. And the Lord God said, it is not good. And when God says something is not good, it's not good. That the man should be alone. I will make him an help meet for him. God categorically said it is not good for a man to be alone. Before we proceed, may I drop this for singles in the house? God is the one who made Adam, who made Eve for Adam. He said, I will make him an helpmeet for him. There is a lady God has made for you. In the place of prayer, you will discover that lady. Because if you don't find the right one God has made for you, your life will be miserable. There is a man for your life from whose rib you have been created as a woman. There is a woman for your life, the one God has ordained to help you actualize your destiny. So as singles, we need to pray that God will show us and guide us to that fellow. We can't afford to live our lives like unbelievers. Oh, I meet her in a party. Oh, this and that. It must be God factor that brings you together for your purpose in life to be fulfilled. It is great to go through bachelorhood and spinsterhood during your youthful days. It is an experience you may never get back after going past that stage in life. Nevertheless, at some point, God wants you to be married. He wants you to have a worthy companion. Today, in many homes, companionship is still lacking even after marriage. You find couples living like cat and rat. They don't enjoy staying with one another. The man is always running out of the house. The woman will find reasons to be late from work. God will show us mercy. So, what are we saying? This is quite unfortunate. Couples marry and stay far apart from each other. This is recipe for disaster and negate the basis for marriage in the first place. Again, I come back to you, young ones, singles in the house, viewing this program. Or you parents, viewing this program so that you can tell your children. Some of us parents, we are after money. Hey, there's one rich guy in America, whereas you are in Ghana. There's one rich guy in UK. Oh, there's one girl there that already has citizenship. And you are in Congo. You want them to be married. There is no sin. There is nowhere in the world that God cannot bring spouse to you or bring spouse to your children. But you should ensure that the reason for marriage is fulfilled, companionship. It's not that one will be living in Congo and the other will be living in South Africa. One will be living in the US, the other one will be living in Cameroon. No, that negates the purpose of God. They have to live together, companionship. God says it is not good for man to be alone. And go and check it. So many marriages that have collapsed today is simply because they don't live together. When you get married, for the first 5 years of your life, or 10 years, you never live together. It's weekend husband. When will you know each other? When will you adjust to one other? To each other? When will you adjust? Daddy is saying, this is fundamental to disaster when, after marriage, couples live far apart from each other. A married relationship cannot be what it was meant to be as long as the vital ingredient of companionship is missing. For this reason, if a couple who have been married for 30 years becomes separated for some 10 or 15 years, by the time they come together again, they will be like total strangers to each other. Are you married? Is your spouse your companion? Some people are ashamed to attend social outings with their wives. Why then did you marry her? That's another point. Companionship. One, the first point is that you should not live far away from each other. You should live together. The second one is that those of you who are even living together, do you enjoy keeping each other's company? Do you enjoy going out together? Or you keep her at home? You see, people like you, they are looking for you in the program. You stay at home. Take care of the children. The question is, why did you marry her? Do you spend time in each other's company? Do you enjoy the company of your spouse? Or do you prefer to keep company with other people? Your legally wedded spouse should be your ideal companion. Is he so with you? That's a question only you can answer. If you find it easier to keep company with others, then something is wrong with your marriage. Key point. Pets are fast replacing human spouses as companions. We are really in perilous times. Let's say, Father, let there be love and harmony in all our homes in Jesus' name. Father, we pray for all our homes. Let there be love, let there be harmony, let there be companionship in the name of Jesus. Whatever it is that have been trying to put couples apart, we come against them today by the power that is in the blood of Jesus. Let's quickly pray for our singles, that God will guide them to the right companion that God has ordained for them. For our singles, Father, we pray that we lead them aright, we divide and connect them to the bones of their bones and the flesh of their flesh in Jesus' name. Everlasting Redeemer, we thank you. Prayer answering God, we appreciate you. We pray, oh God, for every married couple viewing this program, that you will bind them together with your cord of love, and they will enjoy the company of one another in the name of Jesus. For all the singles, my Father, I pray that we guide them to the rightful spouse you have ordained for their lives in Jesus' name. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Can we please sing hymn 16?
Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it rain.